So when you open your closet door and you look inside, is like everything hanging there something that you love and you can be like, wow, this is like a little store curated just for me? Obviously, that's the goal for all of us, but I feel like most of us are pretty far from that point. Today, I'm gonna go through several different reasons why I believe that our closets are not working for us. I did a whole decluttering video last winter, and I highly recommend that video. I use that system now to this day. In fact, here's my closet. Okay, so here is my closet. It's attached to our bedroom. It's actually, I mean, I think it's big. It's big enough for us. Josh's stuff is just along the back here. It's actually decently organized. This is my color coordination system that I did last year. If you want more organization motivation, definitely go check that video out. But this color system has worked. I've been using it now for 365 days and I love it. And then I have t-shirts over here and I probably wear like 6 or 7 of them, so I need to pare down. Scarves, I never wear them. I don't know if I'm just done with scarves now or, yeah, I guess I should technically get rid of all of them, but I don't know, we'll see. And then I have so many pullover sweaters and I wear like maybe 5 of them at the most. And then my other sweaters are on hangers in here. So yeah, my shoes, we can take a look at those. But anyway, oh, here is my one extra bag. I don't collect bags really, so I have the one I use and then I have this one. This is Josh's belts and his hoodie that he has for quick grabbing. So, and then this side over here is like seasonal stuff. My wedding dress is here. And just some stuff that's kind of like in limbo, see if I miss it or not. And some summery things that I'm obviously not gonna be wearing right now. So I have plenty of space in here so I don't have to take things and put them in another room or under the bed or anything. So that's really nice. And then that's Josh's shoes and my shoes. I probably should pare these down a little bit, but yeah, this closet works, but I don't wear near everything. And let's discuss why.
Doesn't even look that junky. I have to clean it up a little bit, but this is just how it looks. Okay, granted, some days the children are in there playing, that they're hunting bears and stuff, and there's clothes on the floor, but for the most part, it stays pretty organized. The coloring system works great. I'm not gonna get into too much details about that because I already made a video on it, so definitely watch that one if you're looking for more closet inspiration. But today I wanna just talk with you about reasons that your clothes are not working for you, you don't love them, you're not wearing them, you're wasting money on them. This video is gonna be informative and fun because I'm gonna show you a bunch of different modest outfit ideas. If you're new to my channel, my name is Megan Fox. I am a Mennonite and we try to dress modestly. The outfits you're gonna be seeing today fall into the modest winter category, I would say. Also, if you're wondering where I am, I will explain that in another video, but I am in my house in the middle of a halfway renovated room and that will all be coming up in the future. But for now, I thought the lighting was great. I'll just film down here and let's get into this. Okay, so this video is not sponsored or anything, but I did want to mention that some of the clothes that I'm wearing today are gonna be coming from my own line, Fox Sparrow. You can find that on meganfoxunlocked.com. We have a bunch of t-shirts, some crew necks, and some of the sizes go the whole way up to 2XL, so definitely check that out. We now have international shipping, and yeah, it's clothes designed by me, so. Also, if you ever feel like bashed in this video because I'm talking about a certain item of clothing that you really like and I'm saying I don't like it, please don't take offense. We all have different styles and we just need to be comfortable in the clothing that we're wearing. So just because it's wrong for me does not mean that it's wrong for you. Please wear the stuff that you love. That's the whole point of this video. Okay, so the first reason that you're probably not wearing something in your closet is because it's just uncomfortable. Nobody wants to wear clothing that is actually painful to wear. I have some shoes that are like that and I hobble around them in church once in a while and I'm always so glad to take them off at the end of the 2-hour service. So here's an example of a skirt that I sewed and I really love it. In theory, it looks really cute, but the waistband is not comfortable at all. It doesn't sit right. I was just still learning how to sew in like waistbands on skirts. And yeah, it's just not comfortable at all. It's the wrong size. So this one has got to go. So purge anything in your closet that you find yourself not reaching for because it's uncomfortable, or figure out a way to make it more comfortable by layering something underneath if it's itchy, cutting off any tags or anything like that, or just getting rid of it if there's really no other solution. The next category of clothing that you should probably get rid of in your closet are all the things that fit weird. This dress here I sewed for some pictures. I wore them for our family pictures the 1 year and I liked how the pictures turned out, but I can't wear this dress in public because it fits weird. One, it's uncomfortable because it moves around a lot at my waist, but two, it makes me look pregnant and it just poofs at the wrong spot. I put too many gathers into the waistband, and so I either need to alter it or just get rid of it. And since it's been flying around for a whole year and I still haven't altered it, I think I'm gonna just like get rid of the guilt and pass it on and just chalk it up as a learning experience. Sometimes you just gotta do that. Another reason your wardrobe is not working for you is because you have clothes in it that are too worn. You know what I mean? Like, they just don't look fresh and clean anymore. They have pullers on them, or they're like pilled, and you just don't reach for them because you don't feel good in them because they feel warm. Here's an example of a shirt that I really love, but it just doesn't look fresh anymore. So what do you do with items like this? There's a couple different options. One, you could pass it on to a thrift store or something, but I would be very careful with that just because if it's too junky for you, it's probably too junky for the next person too. So just acknowledge that you loved it. You wore, like this shirt, I wore a lot. And there's a reason that it looks not fresh anymore. So just acknowledge that you wore it, it served its purpose, and you know, sometimes we just do have to throw things out. For this particular shirt, I'm not gonna get rid of it. I'm actually gonna try to buy one of those little fabric shavers and see if I can freshen it up a little bit. And if that doesn't work, then it's gotta go. But when something is just too worn, that doesn't actually have to be a bad thing. This gray skirt here, I love so much, but I got a grease stain on it, and so therefore I can't really wear it out in public anymore, but I wear it all the time around the house when I think somebody's not gonna see me because I just love it so much. And sometimes that is like trying to speak to us and say, hey, this is my style. This is something that works in my life. This is something I wear a lot, and it would probably be a good idea to rebuy it. So this skirt here I think is from Inherit Clothing Company. I will put a link for them down below. But yeah, I really like this skirt a lot and I think I should reorder it because I really miss it. Another category of clothing you probably have in your closet that you're not wearing are things that are just too much work to wear. Maybe you have a wrap dress that you have to fold just right. Here is a shirt that I really love the concept of. I got it at Kmart when I was going out of business, and I love the little tie detail at the hip. But as I wear it, it like flips up underneath, and I'm always like wrenching at it and moving it around and trying to make it look nice, trying to get that excess fabric to my hip rather than right in the front and have like a big pouch. It's just too much work to wear. It fits weird, you could put it under that category. But at the end of the day, I think it looks nice in that one position, but at the end of the day, it's just too much work to wear. So this one is gonna go. Another reason your clothing might need to be passed on is because there's just missing buttons or an unworking zipper or something like that. Here is a denim shirt that I really love. I like this whole outfit. I just actually wore it in my last pantry makeover video that you guys really loved. I really enjoyed chatting with you guys in the comments, so watch that if you have not yet. But yes, this shirt, I really like it. It looked fine for the video because you couldn't really tell. But in real life, I'm always just subconsciously like thinking, is somebody gonna notice that it's missing a button? You just don't feel confident like that, right? So I could take the time to tear off all the buttons, but this shirt is like 7 years old and you can find like chambray shirts all over the place. So I'm just gonna move this one along and keep my eye open for another one because I know it's something that I wear. I mean, I wore it out. But then you might have something like this shirt here. I love this striped shirt. It is really, really cute and it's definitely my style. I like how it has pattern without being obnoxious. And I feel like this is a print that a lot of people love, like that black pinstripe on white. But it has a really wide boat neck and I have to always wear an undershirt underneath it. Well, it's white for one thing, but two, that neck is just kind of wide. And I still wear this shirt anyway because I find that it's worth the hassle. I don't mind that I have to do that because I just like how it looks. So that's a learning experience right there to try to find another shirt with maybe a different cut around the neck, but in that same print, because I know it's me and I really like it and I'm finding myself wearing it even though it is a pain to wear. So yeah, think about things like that and think about how you can keep those things in mind when you're shopping. Okay, here's the next one. It's a big one. You should be getting rid of all the clothing in your closet that does not fit. And this is really hard. And I know like for myself, I'm a little bit gentle for myself in this category. I've had two babies, I'm 28, I'm probably gonna have more kids, Lord willing. And yeah, sizing fluctuates and that's just a fact of life. It's not a huge deal. But depending on the age you are, and if you think back and you're like, I've been the same weight for the last like 5 years, but you're still hanging on to clothes, you should probably just get rid of them if they're not fitting you and you have no reason to believe that they're gonna fit you anytime soon. I know it feels maybe disappointing that you're not the size that you want to be, or you know, you loved it at the time when it did fit, but you know, you're just not gonna be able to wear it again. Pass it along. Maybe at the time you are the weight that you're hoping you'll be at, you can go shopping for some new stuff as a reward or whatever. It's just like a mental clutter in your closet. And one thing that I found for myself is that it's so nice when you walk into your closet and everything is an option, if you know what I'm saying. If you really don't wanna get rid of some of your clothing, you could potentially just put it in like a storage bin under your bed, or in a separate closet, something like that, out of sight kind of. For me, my closet's so big, I can just move things across to the other side if I wanted to. But yeah, maybe just get it out of your normal clothing so you're not seeing it every day and like having to bypass it or whatever, because you know you're not gonna wear it. Here is a shirt that I'm just gonna get rid of because I bought it thinking, oh, I'll knot it at the hip and it'll look cute and whatever. I just don't like how it fits me. I think I got it in like an extra large just because I like the print. And we were going camping, I'm like, oh, this is perfect. Even if they don't have a medium, I'll just get the big oversized shirt and knot it up. But I don't find myself reaching for it at all, especially now that I'm designing my own t-shirts. I'm finding myself reaching for shirts like this. This one, I just love this quote. It says, hand holder, heart molder, homemaker, world shaker. Yes, I'm a mom. And really, that says it all, doesn't it? Anyway, so I'm not reaching for that green shirt, so it's gotta go. Get rid of all the clothing that you find is not a flattering color on you. If you feel sickly or just not very attractive whenever you find yourself wearing a certain color, just get rid of it. If you're not reaching for it, you have other clothes that suit you better, just pass it along. It doesn't mean it's bad. This brown sweater I loved. I kept it for so long, but I just never find myself getting it because every time I put it on, I just feel like dull and like colorless, and I kind of feel like one of those people in those like old fashioned sepia pictures. See, I'm like all the same color. I'm just like brown and tan, brown and tan. So this is just not a sweater I reach for, so I'm gonna let it go. And I did want to say, with like colors that flatter you, there's so many different videos out there. There is a Justine here on YouTube. I'll try to link her down below. She has a lot of good videos about like your different coloring and what you should wear for certain colors and stuff like that, color matching. But at the end of the day, I would just wear whatever colors you want, and then just notice if you ever feel just like extra drab or something in a certain color and you just don't like it, well then don't wear it. You're probably the only one who's gonna really notice anyway. I guess it depends what stage of life you're into. Anyway, I really like that whole color theory thing. I kind of get into it. But at the end of the day, wear the stuff that you love, and that's what will look best on you anyway. So another category of clothing you should probably declutter is anything that you have a better option of. So basically duplicates. So here is a black skirt that I like. It's fine, but I just have other skirts that I like better. This one is just not quite as black. And so I find like not knowing if I should wear it like a gray skirt or like a black skirt. Again, the shirt I'm wearing here you can find on meganfoxunlocked.com. But this skirt, I just have other options. Guys, I love black skirts, and this is how many I own. I have a long one, I have a dressy one, I have a shorter one, I have a sporty one, and I wear them all, and so I'm gonna keep them. I have no guilt in that. I wear them so often, except for this one here. I just have too many other options. I don't find myself reaching for it, like I said. So this black skirt, I'm gonna declutter, but the other five, I'm keeping them. Okay, this next category, I really had a hard time trying to find something from my closet as an example, because I don't like to have a lot of extras in my closet, and so I'm pretty ruthless with at the end of every season making sure that, you know, I like all the stuff in my closet. But this next category is getting rid of anything that you have nothing else to go with it. So whatever that means for you. For me, I found this cardigan here that I rarely wear. I am keeping it though because I still get enjoyment out of it, and I enjoy it. I wear it occasionally, but this cardigan here, I don't have a lot to wear with it. I recently got this blue inherit skirt, and I think it looks really cute with it, so I'm keeping it for now. We will see as the next year goes on. Maybe it'll be time to pass it on. Maybe not, but I encourage you to get rid of anything that you just don't have anything to wear it with. Maybe you have a scarf that you really like on its own, but you don't have an outfit for it. And sometimes, you know, it's worth going out shopping for something else that specifically goes with that item that you have nothing to wear with. But for the most part, those pieces just aren't really worth keeping just because they probably don't fit into your personal style anyway. And I don't know, maybe they should just go. Okay, so here's the next category. Maybe you have clothing in your closet that you just have nowhere to wear it to. Thinking specifically of like dressy clothes, maybe you got them for a wedding, but you really have no weddings in the near future. You have like six dressy dresses, like super dressy dresses, or maybe you dress up a ton at your church. That's great too, go for it. I personally get a lot of wear out of my Sunday clothes because we do go to church every week, but those extra special occasion dresses, I have a feeling most of us have too many. Or maybe it's just a style that you find that you never wear. Here I got really brave and I bought this like capelet, and I really love it. Guys, I like it. It looks cute. Even in this image here, I think it looks adorable. But I just have nowhere to wear it. I'm a mom. I can't just go running around and have like this capelet on. I guess in my mind I was like, oh, it'd be cute to go to like the pumpkin patch in or something like that. But I've had this for 3 years and I've never worn it once out the door. So I probably should get rid of it, or maybe I should just save it and hope for next fall. Or maybe you just quit your job and you're now a stay-at-home mom or something. If you guys are so blessed to be stay-at-home moms, I hope you're enjoying it. But anyway, let's say you were working in a corporate job and now you are at home and you're not wearing all that dressy clothing. Maybe just keep like two or three things and just get rid of the rest. Somebody else is probably gonna be really excited for your gently used clothes. The next category, I don't think you should get rid of, but I definitely think you need to move it. And I talk more about this in my other video, but basically you need to get rid of any clothing that is not in the current season. Why is it hanging there amidst all your other stuff when you know you're not gonna reach for it for at least another 3 months? It's just visual clutter again, and you have to bypass it every time you're picking out clothing. So like this skirt here, I actually just found in my closet. I still hadn't moved it over to my other side for my summery stuff. I guess in my mind I thought, hey, I can wear this in the winter because I was wearing it in the fall, but I'm not reaching for it. It's very thin and I think it looks better with sandals, so I'm just not wearing this in the summer. So I'm moving it over to the other side. I'm excited to wear it again, and I want to keep it, but I don't need to see it every day as I'm trying to pick out a skirt because I'm never going to pick this one, at least for now. Or here's another really pretty white dress that I love so much, but I, you know, you can wear a white dress in the winter, why not? But I just, it felt too summery to me. I thought maybe I'd wear it with a cardigan or something, but no, it just looks like I need to be in a field of wildflowers or something like that. So this one's getting moved back over to the other side too. Okay, this last one might be a little bit controversial, but I'm gonna give you guys permission to get rid of anything that is not your style. Anything that looks frumpy to you, or it's just you want to like it and it's just not you. It doesn't fit into your lifestyle, it's not your personality. Probably the chances are the stuff in this category looks really nice yet. You know, it's probably like almost brand new because you just never wear it. So I'm giving you permission right now to pass those things along. Here is a tassel-y shirt, like big oversized blouse that I got at a thrift store near me. It's actually from Target. It was new with tags. I was excited about it. I took it home and I just have not been wearing it at all. I just don't love it. It's not me. I mean, there's so many things I could say about it that I don't like. If you like it, that's awesome. It's just not me. I'm not reaching for it. Also, the skirt I am wearing with it is from Amazon, and I will link it down below. I really like it. Size up, like two sizes, I would say. It's pretty fitted. But yeah, it's a great, like, dressier, thinnish, comfy skirt, and I think you guys would like it. Here is another shirt that I got on Amazon. I recommended to you guys. I like it. I think it looks cute, but honestly, it's just not my style. I don't like this kind of floral. I'm more like a mini floral girl. Like this dress here, I love it. I got it from the Main Street Exchange, and I just love the tiny little floral on it, the moody colors. That is so me. And somebody else looks at that and is like, wow, it's a prairie dress. Like my husband, he thinks I look like a grandma in it, but I feel so elegant and dressy in it. Love this print. And that's completely subjective. It's not wrong to like the style that you like, and don't feel like you have to like what everybody else is liking. Your style is your style, and you shouldn't have to apologize for it. So I hope this video accomplished two things. One, it gave you ideas for what you want to declutter in your closet. You will just love like the peace of mind of opening your closet and knowing that everything you love and you wear and you like, and yeah, it's just an awesome feeling. And I highly recommend the color coding system. It works great for me. You can find things easily and it looks pretty too. But I also hope this video was fun and just gave you some different modest outfit ideas. I know I showed you a lot of different outfits, but maybe you had like one or two of the pieces that I showed and you're like, oh, I have that same shirt. I could wear it with this skirt or vice versa, whatever. It's always nice to get new inspiration with the clothing that we already have. And I think the most important thing to remember is your home is your haven. You have control. And sometimes it just takes a little bit of time and intention to get it to a place where you like it. Just remember, you don't need to be heating and cooling clothing that you're never gonna wear. It's just, you don't need to do that. So I'm giving you permission. Go declutter all those different categories. You can refer to this video later when you're ready to declutter. And I guess I never mentioned the outfit I'm wearing now. I sewed this myself a couple years ago, right before my one sewing video blew up. And now people want more sewing videos from me, so I guess I better get on that. But first, I'm gonna have to get this sewing room done. Well, did I tell you what this is gonna be? You'll see it in the future. It's not just a sewing room. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this one, and I'll see you all in the next one.